bring us to our final bottle or final battle question. What could Call of Duty do? What does Call of Duty have to do to get you guys to come back to the next installment of Call of Duty? I know, Chachi, you said you're going to get it. I'm on the fence. Mikey, you said you probably wouldn't play it. They announced today that you get a free upgrade if you buy it digitally. Like, say you bought it on Xbox 360 for up to, till I think it was March 31st, 2015, you can upgrade your digital version to the Xbox One or PS4 if you bought it for the 360. Like, say you weren't going to get a console yet, mm-hmm. and then you decide later on you want to get a new console, you can upgrade it like that. They did that same thing kind of for Destiny 2. Is that enough? I don't think it's enough. What do you guys think?
You know what Call of Duty has to do to get me to buy the next game?
Mm-hmm.
Release a game. Because, I mean, granted, The 6 to 8 hour story mode isn't enough for the game to exist. Right. However, what I'm hoping is that they fix all of the problems with the Ghost multiplayer so that I'm not running around for 12 minutes trying to find someone to kill.
Yeah, that's what happened with the last one. I had the last one. I didn't even play it barely at all because I think we were all on for like a couple weekends, and then it got boring. Man.
Yeah, we dropped off real fast on the last one.
We're huge and everything, and then I think I started like getting kind of, I don't know, disheartened with it when they started just adding on all the maps like right after the game would come out. It'd be like, it wasn't too long, and then it's just like, oh, new map pack is out. And, like, the first time it was kind of cool, and then it's just like, oh, another map pack is out. So then you just feel like, you know, oh, I only have the original levels, and it just became too much. I don't know. For some reason, it just, like, stopped being fun, kind of, you know? I think they just took it too serious and tried to get too crazy with it instead of just kind of keeping it what it was.
Didn't it seem like they were kind of more serving the clans and the teams and like the bigger experiences? And maybe that's what they left us more casual people behind, except for Chachi.
Space.
Well, yeah. What can I say? I'm good at the game. I wouldn't say I'm ready to go pro, but I mean, I wasn't afraid. I'll admit, there was one night where I just completely rage quit and lost it and just shut the Xbox off and went to bed. But, I mean, other than that, I can get into any game and hold my own.
If you went pro, what would your competition screen name be?
Chachi Says.
Okay.
I wouldn't change my name just because I went pro.
Be like, 4 kills.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying, though, Sorg. I feel that, you know, with all the clans and the people who, like, you know, take a game like that, like, really serious, you know? I mean, a lot of us just used to play, like, on the weekend, like, Friday and Saturday night for a couple hours, you know, and it'd be fun, but, you know.
And there was definitely that level of, because some of us wouldn't hit every Friday night, but by the time some of us would pop in, everybody was so far advanced, or there was map packs, or there was this, and there was a lot of leaving friends behind.
The map packs are what did it for most of us, I think.
Yeah.
Nobody would get the map packs, and everybody would just be like, oh, I'm done.
Yeah, that's what it was, man. Or if you didn't buy the, like, the, you know, upgraded version when it came out that gave you, like, an extra level or two or something like that. You know, I don't know.
I think the peak of it with all of us was Modern Warfare 2.
Yeah.
Because they had levels like Rust and just small contained levels, you know? I don't know. Black Ops was pretty big with us, too, I think, though.
I mean, they didn't really have a level like that in the last one at all. Like,
they were all giant levels.
Yeah.
The best were those frantic levels, like the boats.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the boat ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Both of those were fun.
Yeah, it was fun when you could go in a level and basically, you know, you couldn't really, you know, find that spot where you could, you know, camp too much or anything like that. Or, you know, even if you were like a badass at the game, there was no way you could really hide out in a place and get too many kills, you know, without it being crazy. I think with the bigger levels, you know, it's more, you know, not for the casual gamer that's just going in there to play, to just kind of have a good time and whatever, kill everything that moves. It's more, you know, for expert people who are actually going to take it pretty serious, sit there and kind of, you know, use sniper rifles and stuff and get their spots and everything. And I don't know, Rust with their grenade launcher was like the greatest time.
I think they should have, they jumped the shark when they took Favela out. My favorite level.
Favorite level, man. Favorite level.